For the first time in history, we may soon witness humans embarking on multi-year journeys to other planets using the SpaceX Starship mega rocket currently in development. In this video, we'll explore what life could be like inside this giant spacecraft as crews travel to and from Mars during missions lasting over 6 months at a time. We'll look at the facilities, communication systems, power supplies, and other critical elements needed to keep passengers healthy, happy, and sane on these unprecedented beyond space voyages. The future of manned deep space exploration may depend on how livable the Starship's interior proves to be. So stay tuned for an inside look at this ship that could one day ferry colonists to other worlds. As this video delves into the realities of the cosmos unveiled through interplanetary travel, it provides a glimpse into potential science and technology advances that could transform space news headlines in the coming years. Determining the crew size for a Mars mission is crucial, as too many or too few astronauts comes with downsides. Packing in 100 people would strain supplies and reduce mental stability from crowding and interpersonal conflicts in tight quarters. But having only 2 or 3 would increase risks of social isolation and boredom over 6+ months. Most experts recommend targeting around 10 crew members as the Goldilocks zone that balances payload capacity, psychology, workload, skills redundancy, and minimizing total trips to establish a colony. With 10 astronauts providing companionship and collaborative duties while affording some personal space, this should mitigate negative behavioral health effects from prolonged confinement better than extreme counts. Plus, with crew rotations, this still allows gradually building up substantial populations on Mars across repeat flights. But the exact number could be tuned based on mock missions and further research into ideal group dynamics and autonomy thresholds for multi-year interplanetary travel. The Starship facilities can be thought of as a vertical stack of purpose-built levels spanning over 17 meters from the cargo bay to the command deck. The lowest deck houses mechanical systems, along with infrastructure and supplies meant for establishing a Mars surface habitat. The next level up provides bulk storage for food and a small greenhouse for supplementing packaged ingredients with some fresh veggies. Deck 3 looks to be home to the onboard gym, which is vital for maintaining fitness. This level also holds bathroom stalls and the specialized toilet and hygiene facilities required in zero gravity. Then come the private crew quarters on Deck 4, which offer personal space to sleep and retreat to. Deck 5 features an open communal area for group activities and possibly a large wraparound window or projections of nature scenes to prevent sensory deprivation. Lastly, Deck 6 forms the command center, with flight control interfaces, displays, and seating to strap into during any critical maneuvering. A central tube connector with ladders and handhold links for all decks for internal transit. Science news headlines in the years ahead may feature exciting discoveries from exoplanets as Starships enable exploring more of the cosmos unveiled. Real-time communication with Earth is often taken for granted, but as the Starship ventures some 140 million miles towards Mars, radio signals will take progressively longer to traverse the vast distance. Just peering outside to see home will be impossible, let alone having a conversation of reasonable duration. After the first few days, communication lags with mission control, which will make video calls frustrating as voices talk over each other. Within a month, delays could approach 5 to 10 minutes each way. And for parts of the trip around conjunction when the sun disrupts signals, blackout periods require full autonomy. These gaps will isolate the crew psychologically in ways rarely experienced before. Coping mechanisms like time-shifted emails Recorded video logs and entertainment media will help. But NASA learnings show that preparation for the Earth out-of-view condition using simulations and a built-in onboard community still often proves inadequate defenses against behavioral disorder risks. Reliable communication technology and protocols, specially designed for hour-plus lags, will be critical for mitigating the profound sense of detachment. Several options exist for powering the Starship systems, each with pros and cons. Solar energy works for the ISS in Earth orbit, but scaling up photovoltaic arrays large enough for a Mars trip may pose engineering hurdles. Transporting sufficient battery storage, like Tesla's Powerwalls, would drive up mass and reduce cargo capacity. Radioisotope generators have reliably lasted for decades on deep space probes, but provide relatively low voltages, making them unsuitable for life support. Instead, SpaceX is eyeing high-power fuel cells that catalytically convert purified hydrogen into electricity. When paired with the liquefied hydrogen propellant already used by Raptor engines, tapping some flow upstream could continually replenish a fuel cell. This resembles how a plug-in hybrid car leverages both batteries and gasoline. Fuel cells have powered NASA space shuttles for decades, and scaling up proven stack designs could generate 100 plus kilowatts. Refining technologies used by company partnerships around renewable hydrogen production and off-grid power grids can make such closed-loop energy systems sustainable for 6 months in deep space. Abundant water generated as a byproduct also gets recycled for the crew. While the Starship will feature exercise areas and multi-purpose spaces for some entertainment, prolonged confinement risks psychological strain without creative recreation options. Supporting activities that distract, simulate, relax, and break up monotonous routines will be vital. Passengers could tap virtual reality simulations and augmented windows to enjoy nature scenes from home. Digital libraries would provide media access spanning books, videos, music, courses, and more. Social events might entail game nights, live performances, debate clubs, trivia, or sporting matches using projected environments. If bandwidth allows, even synchronized movie nights with Earth could maintain a sense of connection, providing materials for arts, crafts, and other creative pursuits gives positive outlets for free time. Scheduled community gatherings help reinforce bonds between travelers to aid crew cohesion. And private communication tools enable intimacy for couples or close confidants stranded together. While no approach prevents all behavior disorders or replaces true freedom, fostering recreational variety and choices provides some countermeasures for enhancing quality of life. Thoughtful interior design involves more than functionality to make prolonged habitation in confined spaces bearable. Material selection, lighting, colors, textures, and patterns all contribute to perceived aesthetics. Using natural tones and textures helps subconsciously reinforce nature's calming effects. Mood lighting, adjusting spectra and intensity levels, promotes circadian alignment. Bold color accents lend visual interest to an otherwise monotonous backdrop. Projecting images or augmented reality views can simulate windows overlooking familiar scenery from home rather than an endless void. Ergonomic workstations ensure crew efficiency and comfort during tasks. Modular or reconfigurable furniture supports multi-purpose areas, adapting to evolving needs and crew activities. Sound-dampening materials reduce noise propagation that could otherwise induce fatigue over time. And customizable quarters allow personalization, enabling astronauts to stake out their niche territory. Accounting for human factors through such interior design choices supplements traditional engineering requirements. This holistic habitat approach fosters not just survival in space, but genuine livability, strengthening astronauts' resilience against challenges to both physical and mental well-being as we push beyond space frontiers. Carrying 6 months of pre-packaged food requires clever solutions balancing nutrition, taste, shelf stability, lower mass, and storage efficiency. Dehydrated ingredients, later rehydrated using recycled water, aid in the cause. But adding some fresh-grown produce provides health benefits over solely preserved items. Feasibility has already been demonstrated via bioregenerative systems aboard the International Space Station, using hydroponic and aeroponic techniques optimized for microgravity and interior lighting that enable growing select vegetables, herbs, and even strawberries. These past prototypes were relatively small in scale, but SpaceX could adapt proven low-footprint, low-power designs now demonstrated as operational in orbit. Expanding growth chambers and plant sites would provide supplemental food variety and key nutrients, benefiting crew morale and better long-term health, critical considering the astronauts' importance in establishing the early Mars colonies. Additional technologies like mycoprotein-rich fungi and microbial bioreactors generating edible probiotic biomass from waste streams offer innovative alternative means to further close the food loop. While bulk nutrition still gets met mainly through stored provisions, space-farmed fresh food plays an outsized role in sustainability for beyond space travel. Without gravity to flush waste down drains, special systems adapt common infrastructure for zero-G reliability. Urine gets collected by personal funnels and then routed to storage bladders. Atmospheric moisture recovery processes maximize water reclamation from these sources. Other volatile organics are concentrated through life support's thermal distillation and chemical processes, rendering water pure enough for drinking. Solid trash is compacted to conserve volume before secure disposal. But the real trick lies in managing bowel movements without making a mess. Space toilets utilize powerful air suction for precise waste transport from special toilet seats directly into compressed bags, sealing in odors. While this isn't glamorous to consider, such innovations enable practical, hygienic, deep space flight. Future systems could raise the bar further, digesting feces using microbes to generate methane fed into a propellant production reactor. Additionally, oxidizing compacted dry waste could break down materials for chemical water and carbon dioxide recovery via vapor phase catalytic ammonia removal techniques studied on the ISS. By developing sustainable waste and recycling ecosystems, long-duration missions become far more feasible. The upcoming Starship has true game-changing potential because of its unprecedented size and mass capabilities. But capitalizing on this fully toward regular interplanetary flights requires holistic livability advances, spanning facilities, services, and the human experience. Visualizing this plausibly achievable future sets the stage for one day settling amongst the stars and expanding deeper into the cosmos unveiled.